Morning!
Hello and welcome to a brand new Disney Cruise Line vlog series. We are currently at Southampton Parking with ABP, which is part of Southampton, and we've been sent over to Dock Gate 20, which is in the backside of nowhere.
I've got Crocs now.
Oh god. Anyway, it's gonna be one of those vlogs. So basically I think ABP parking is either like overfull or something, so they've sent us to where a lot of the shipping stuff is. I don't know if you can see it over there. They've got like the shipping container equipment and stuff. And basically what we're doing here is we're dropping our bags in this tent over here, and then we're gonna get a shuttle over to the ship.
Hello.
Just doing your last minute shenanigans, as per usual.
I can feel moistness, so I'm wondering if something's split. But you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to seal this up.
I'll deal with it later.
That's future Gareth's problem.
Well, welcome to this new series. If you're a brand new subscriber, don't forget to make sure you are subscribed and have your notifications on so you know when the next vlog's coming out. And yeah,
oh, the plastic's the ship. Stuck in the zip.
Gotta drop the bags over here.
Testing. This is the old testing place, I think.
Yeah, probably, yeah.
Goodbye, my luggage.
Thank you. Just straight down there and ask someone in the high vis and they'll get you on the right bus.
Thank you.
This is a very different scenario, isn't it?
We are sailing on the Disney Dream for a week around the British Isles.
We're going anti-clockwise round.
Yes.
And then...
So we go like round the top and then go to Belfast, Liverpool, Greenock, no.
Belfast,
Greenock. Greenock in Scotland, Liverpool, Cork in Ireland, Weymouth.
Sounds home. About right.
And we've got a day at sea as well. So we managed to get a really good deal on this, which is why we've actually ended up doing it. We saw a guaranteed rate like 90 to 120 days before. Well, we basically got half price and we thought,
let's do it.
Why not?
Disney Cruise Transfer.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, this isn't bad, is it?
Very nice.
Mr. Gary C, how does it feel to be returning to the Disney Dream?
I'm very excited. I love the Disney Dream, as I've said many times before. It's my first year, as I've also said many times before. But I do love it. I love the opulence of it. My favourite time is actually when you walk on and they say your name and that. I'm like, yes, it's begun.
What are you most looking forward to?
Characters.
Well, that's the thing, on the last time we came on the Dream.
Hopefully it's not as busy, so the character lines aren't as long. And stick around, because Pirate Night, someone's got a new little trick up their sleeve. Oh yeah! I don't know what he's got.
That's the Horizon Cruise Terminal there, that's where we went from in 2021.
Was it?
Yeah!
Join me now, the take you down
memory lane. Do you want to see that series? Go back to the link below.
There's playlists for all the series we've done together, so you can just sit, click, watch.
Yeah. What's that ship over there?
A blue one with white on it.
I think it's the Royal Caribbean.
This week on Gary C's Insane, I'm obsessively looking at the weather of all the different places we're going to. And as you can see right now, it's looking bleak.
But it was looking, because we've had like a heat wave.
Yeah, we had a heat wave. But we'll see.
Stay tuned.
We are parked at Dock Gate 20, and it seems that the Disney Dream is in Dock Gate 4.
I think we're going to be going from the same terminal as last time, the Queen Elizabeth II.
Did I get it? I got it. Well, I got it.
So our port arrival time is 11:30 a.m. We got here at 10 past 11. So we're just waiting to be let into the actual terminal to check in. So that when we did concierge, you skipped this bit.
Oh, okay.
That's good to know. We've already noticed, because this cruise is outside of terminal time, this is like mid-September. Mm-hmm. There's like next to no kids. I can see maybe a few toddlers, and that's about it. And this was a lot louder when we were coming through. Mm. Listen to this.
It's just a soft hum.
If you happen to get here a lot before your allotted check-in time, you'll end up waiting in this waiting area. There's a lot of people that, you know, want to check in, so I wouldn't recommend coming early if you're coming from the UK. We're now waiting in the terminal.
Hello.
So
it's very busy.
It is very busy. We're boarding group 7. So we're hoping that we get a chance to get on and get to cabanas before it gets too busy, because we are hungry. There is a separate waiting area for concierge guests. When we came through, we got straight on because we were late.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, it's very full. And we were kind of hoping that this cruise was going to be not full. So it turns out the UK cruises are very popular. To the ship!
Hello!
Hello! This cruise is not to France, but bon voyage!
Let's go, let's go.
Sail away, sail away. What songs were you listening to on the train down?
I'm listening to the greatest hits of Kylie Minogue. I was cherry picking all my favourites from all the different albums since the 1980s. Niche. Here we go.
Hi!
What are our first two names or our last names?
Adam and Gary, please.
Adam and Gary.
Disney Dream is welcome aboard Adam and Gary.
Thank you!
In a guaranteed stateroom, you get assigned a stateroom. So we're currently on 5528, which is on the level as the kids' clubs. And because we're two adults, it doesn't really make sense for us to utilise that. So I'm going to see if they've got anything available by just coming to guest services the second we've got on board. There is no line to meet Mickey Mouse, so Gary's just run up to go and get him whilst I do this.
Hello. Can you see that?
I think so, just about, yeah.
Just a bit Mickey Mouse.
She's happy. Since the line is so short to meet Mickey Mouse, we figured this would be a good thumbnail. So we're now going to go meet Mickey Mouse with no line! Which is, you know, the complete opposite of what the last one was. How long did we wait for Mickey Mouse last time?
I don't know, but Captain Hook was 1 hour and 15 minutes.
Gary got a hug, but I didn't get a hug. Can I have one? Thank you so much. I'm loving your outfit. It's very sparkly.
I'm back.
For the 25th, right? Do you have to take it off soon? Are they getting rid of the 25th anniversary? Oh, that's a shame.
No, not the sparkly outfit.
Next 30, yeah? We're on our way to cabanas, but since we're passing through deck 4 in the adults only area, it's actually nice and quiet right now, so this might be a good opportunity to show the adult area.
Yeah, so this is district lounge.
So we didn't really show them on the last time we came on. This is where they do kind of like the cabaret acts. This is where we won the quiz.
Yes, we did win a chicken dinner.
The pink wine and champagne bar.
Oh, it's lovely.
Ooh.
Oh, it's nice and cold in here.
And a fun fact I learnt from Jen is that if you stare at the bubbles, you can see the heffalumps and woozles. They appear.
Oh.
Let me see if I can find one. There it is!
I see it.
There it is! Can you see it? It's gone. Alright. Well, I tried. This is the 687 pub, which is named after the number of ship that was built in the actual shipyard. Hello!
Welcome.
And they've got like...
It was very different the last time.
It was very, very different. They've got the pictures of the ship being built there. A few board games if one's coming here. Oh, we could come in here and play Monopoly, Gary. Why?
He's hardcore. He takes everything.
I can't help it that I'm an entrepreneur. I love the bar. Like, it's so nicely detailed. Now, if you come to the adults only area in the evening, they do actually put a buffet in here. So you can get some light bites in the evening, which we're going to try and do the adults areas a bit more this time, aren't we, GC?
Yes, we are.
Because we didn't do them at all. I think we only went to Skyline Lounge with your friend. Evolution is the nightclub here on the Disney Dream. So this is similar to the Tube on the Fantasy and Fathoms on the Magic. Ooh.
Soaking up, girls, you ain't never going to see this side again.
Yeah, this gets very, very busy in the evening.
All the booze isn't there.
So you can't thieve it. I'm not much of a drinker. The district, which is where all of these bars and clubs and everything are located, are deck 4 aft. This does become an adults only after 9 p.m, but kids are allowed to pass through and come to quizzes and stuff during the day. There are some activities that are 18 plus, so just check on the navigator app.
The magical doors.
Ooh.
Ooh, nice.
Would
you like to drink?
I'll take a gin and tonic, please.
Even though you are allowed to walk around and nose at stuff, it always feels naughty when there's no one around. It's like, ooh, no touch.
The windows in the skyline actually change every 15 minutes to a new city. And as well as that, also the picture over here changes as well.
And the drinks are themed as well, so...
You get an iPad and you can choose from all the different ones.
All the drinks from around the world.
Yeah. Should we go and get some lunch?
Let's go to wherever we're going to go.
Cabanas. I'm knackered, we haven't even started.
I'm trying to get a picture without me in it.
You trying to get a picture?
No, how dare you. Yes.
The audacity!
I took 600 and something last time. That's after I culled loads of them, so, but it was actually over 1,000. Ooh!
Going up.
I've already met Mickey Mouse. Twice.
Oh, well, we're doing better than characters on this cruise already.
I've already achieved the same amount of characters as I did last one.
The buffet is open inside, however, it's very, very, very warm inside. And if we get a seat under the cabana, we'll be fine. Because we're in cabanas. Hurrah! Weather could be a little bit better, but...
I don't know what you're talking about.
You don't... You know there's an entire room full of people with windows that are looking out at you right now. Hi! There's a real juxtaposition between, like, the Caribbean fun music and this.
I have opted for the turkey, which looks incredible. Cranberry sauce, some bread. I'm thinking, what are they called? Carrots, Gary, that's what they're called. And some chips. So, not too much, just enough.
I've gone for a real mixed variety this time. I wanted to try a little bit of everything. I know that the chicken and rice is really good. I've also gone for a salad, which I don't normally do. I got some of the turkey to try and Gary's recommendation, and it is...
amazing.
Christmas dinner!
It is, and it comes with cranberry sauce. And like,
oh, I didn't get any of that. I'm gonna steal that.
Yeah, try it with the cranberry sauce.
This isn't just any turkey breast. This is Disney Cruise Line's Cabana's turkey breast.
Good, isn't it? So this is the celebration cupcake. This is the carrot cake, which
I know I love their carrot cake.
And this is the cookie. So let's do a little cookie test from the cookie connoisseur. Very nice. Yep.
I know with all this delicious food, it's kind of blasphemy to say, but my favorite thing is these like little cheese cubes. They're just so addictive. One of the bartenders was passing. I was like, are you interested in the water package? And I've done it before with my friend Jen when we sailed in the Dream to Greece. And like, after that experience, it was really handy having that. When we bar sailed together, we had the little fridge with all the waters in, so we would never use that. So, because we're on here for a week, I've gone for it, and depending on how quickly we go through it, we might can either top it up, or that might just be perfect. And Gary gets a free bag.
Love a free bag.
Vanellope Sweet Shop. Gary's very excited to see you in here.
I am. Is it locked? No.
Thank you.
There we go.
Hi! Ooh, it smells nice. I didn't realise they'd given a model of you to the ship. actually, do that. That's a good picture. You gotta go cross-eyed. If you can. Put your right... That's it. Are you going to get a picture in the car?
Yes, I am. Why do you think we're in here?
Plotting deck 11. These are the hot tubs in the family pool. But they're quite cool because you can look through the bottom and out the bottom of the ship.
Can you?
Yeah, so if you have goggles, you can go and have a look.
Now I'm all right.
We were talking to one of the cast members just outside cabanas, and she said, even though the ship's not full people-wise, it is full stateroom-wise because there's a lot of couples. Mm-hmm. So pretty much every stateroom is gone. We've got a couple that's in it. We're not a couple, we're friends. Disclaimer. So for that reason, we want to go and just double check. We put in a request for a private table to see if it's still there.
On embarkation day before 2 p.m, if you come down to deck 2 near Enchanted Garden, they have some tables set up over here. These are the cast members that represent each different restaurant on board and the spa. So if you want the main dining room, Paolo, Remy, if you've had any requests or like maybe you tried to get a reservation and can't get one, you can come here and then try to see if there's anything available or join a waitlist for Paolo. So say for example, we've got a Paolo reservation, but if we cancelled ours, then someone who's joined the waitlist would be able to get our spot.
Oh, right, okay.
With the main dining room, because you, if you make requests, they're not always approved. So I always recommend to come and just double check if it has been approved or not, because ours wasn't.
Oh, it wasn't.
So he was actually said, he actually managed to like, he's like, okay, we can just try and get you one. So he luckily did, because when we're vlogging, we don't want to disturb other people at dinner. So,
handy.
Good.
Good thing we did it.
The Bibbidi Bobbidi Boutique is located on deck 5 here on the Disney Dream. It is open between 12 and 3 for inquiries, but not actually appointments, I don't think. So they've got all the dresses on the side that they can choose from, and they do a hair, makeup, nails. And what I really like is they've started doing like more boys targeted outfits.
Look.
So there's a little prince costume over here. Very cute. And they've also got Captain! I love that. I wonder if they get those with it as well, like the autograph book and
stuff. The little book.
Oh, it's lovely.
I love the little prince outfit.
Reservations for Bibbidi Bobbidi Boutique are particularly busy on sea days and formal nights, so make sure you plan ahead if you want to make a reservation either before you get on the cruise. I think this one comes under onboard fun.
I just want to stay in here.
Do you have any vodka?
Thank you.
I love how they've got a little area.
If you want to come back for some pixies, you can come whenever you want.
Oh, well, don't mind if we do.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you. And you do something different on pirate night, right?
Yes, but unfortunately during this
voyage,
you're kidding. The fairy godmother in training in the Bibbidi Bobbidi Boutique said, oh, we don't have pirate night on this cruise. And we were like, we both bought outfits. And then she was like, oh, no, just in the boutique. Just in the boutique. We just met Rapunzel. She was just, we were passing the staircase. And as she was going downstairs, I went, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair. And she went, oh, hello. And so we managed to get a picture with her very quick. The rooms aren't open until 1:30 p.m. So we've got some time to kill. We're going to have a look at the kids' clubs. I think this is in the funnel. Yep, it's in the funnel.
Why are you going to be so many stairs?
Right, Gary, you're on a ship. Sometimes you gotta take the stairs. In Edge, this is ages 11 to 14.
/ 42.
And the rest. Sing over the copyright.
Where did this come from? Mate,
where did it come from?
To wipe my hands.
Da 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 da.
Obligatory picture. Since this spa and salon. Join me now.
Welcome to Spars with Gary C. Hello. Good, how are you?
Just come for a look around.
Oh, okay. Would you like me to take you around?
Yeah, sure.
That'd be great.
If you're free, that'd be great.
This is actually our barber station. So this is where we actually take care of our procollagen grooming treatment. So it's more like it's a double cloth shave with a hydrating facial.
Okay. Teeth whitening. Great for some people. Is the fitness center open to everyone?
Yes, yeah. So it's open from 6 o'clock in the morning until 10.
6 until 10?
Yes.
Every day?
Yeah, every day.
Awesome.
Rainforest room.
I have been on the dream, but I haven't been in your rainforest room.
Oh!
So this is all new.
Yeah.
And how much is it for the whole cruise this time?
It's $159 per person.
We just showed the lovely cast member who's showing us around the clip of Gary reacting to the cold shower on the magic. She's laughing her head off. Oh. I am very tempted to get the rainforest room pass again.
Are you?
I really liked it. Oh, wow!
Oh, this is good.
Did you hear him? He said, don't part of another couple.
Oh my word.
This is nice, right?
This is amazing. Lovely. What's the name of this room?
So this is a couple's choice.
Couple's choice?
Couple's choice or romantic hideaway. So you can either do the romantic hideaway or the couple's choice. So the difference is that the romantic hideaway you can only.
We had the best tour of the spa with Lami. She showed us around and we laughed and laughed and laughed. My favourite thing was when she said, so if you've got deep set wrinkles, I looked at Gary and Gary was like, what do you look at me when you say that?
She was like, I'm not, was I? He was.
Right, we're going to have a look at our room. So we are in 5528. 5528, here we are. Okay, now you did get to open it last time. I really want to open it this time. So this is something that started during the pandemic and they've kind of stuck with it where they put the cards on the stateroom door. So you just, oh.
I broke the tap. 1 second.
This isn't part of it. That's you. New cards!
And we're in.
We booked a guaranteed rate where basically you don't know which stateroom you're going to get and Disney just randomly assigns you one. But the great thing is that if you book at the right time, you get mega deals. And when I say we got this half the cost of full price, I'm not joking. We saved thousands of pounds. So basically this is a family veranda room because it has the full length of a family veranda room, but it doesn't have the bathtub. And it doesn't have the extra square footage inside because it's actually on the veranda, which we'll see
outside
in just a second. But if you are just booking a normal ocean view with veranda, so not a family one, this is the same size inside that you will have. So we'll start at the beginning. Let's start from the very beginning.
The room is occupied.
A very good place to start.
Let's start with the little wardrobes. Very nice. Laundry bag, safe, some spacious, oh, lots of hangers this time.
Ooh.
Loads of hangers, which is good. I haven't brought many clothes.
Haven't you? This is a longer cruise than the last one.
I know, I don't know why. God, there's a lot of life jackets. What are they trying to say? Do I need loads stitched together?
Well, plus your wrinkles, two life jackets.
Every wrinkle.
I didn't get a chance to see. So there is some storage in there. So the good thing is that with two of you, you can basically have one cupboard each, which is quite handy.
ASMR.
Disney are really known for their split bathrooms, so half of the bathroom is in one side, half is in the other, which means if you have more than one person in the stateroom, you can get ready together.
Which we do.
Separately.
Which we do.
Here's the loo. What are you laughing at?
Just the way we're both like, we do get separately, just in case you're wondering.
So in this room, you do get the H2O products, which we absolutely love. We do know that something with H2O products means they're going to go away soon, maybe, but...
In concierge, you requested H2O, didn't you?
Yeah.
You didn't want the enemies.
Because I like the smell of the H2O, like it just reminds me of Disney Cruise Line, you know?
Yeah.
So there's like a little foot mat that they put down in there. This is the bathroom, so you've got a full-length mirror on the door. Yes. Two towels there, you've also got some shelving. It's quite a nice size, actually.
Yeah, it is, I thought that.
I, for some reason, just... It actually feels a little bit more spacious than the other bathroom because it's all open.
Yeah,
it's so bigger. If you push that curtain all the way back, you can swing a cat in it.
It feels bigger than the concierge one.
Please don't, animal rights.
Touch the towels, towel toucher. What are you talking? Rough?
Very rough.
Sandpaper rough. Cow toucher says?
No comment.
Oh no!
I like Disney Cruise Line too much to say anything. Le bed?
It's not my bed, it's yours. So I won't throw myself on it.
Who said it was my bed?
Oh, I'll have it then. Right.
Them's the rules.
You can have the bed if you help me back up because I've put myself in a very precarious situation.
Anyway, let me show you the other side of the room.
I'm like a turtle upside down.
A very wrinkly turtle.
Oh God, we're not playing that game, are we? Old facelift Felicia.
So as you pan around to here, this is like the table bit. Gary behind
Hello.
The cupboard. There's a drawer which has some postcards, stationery, and these will be thieved by Mr. GC.
Maybe.
TV and also Castaway Club goodies. I have shown these in a previous Disney Cruise Line vlog, Embarkation Day, so if you haven't seen them, go and check it out in that vlog. But we've got our lanyards.
Oh, yeah. Gold.
In here, there is a fridge. There is a little table that can be moved around quite easily. This turns into a sofa bed, which you'll see later in the vlog series, but as a little preview, it folds down like this.
Ta-da! Casa de C!
Casa de C! Above the sofa bed, you have a little light for the bed, which they turn on in the evening, which is lovely, because they do turn down service on Disney Cruise Line. And I was just talking to my parents who did a P&O cruise recently, and apparently they don't do turn down service anymore. I've really cut back on the times that they do housekeeping and everything.
I don't even know what it means. What is this turn down service, you ask yourself?
That's where the chocolates and the towel animals come from.
Oh, no towel animals. I've got these.
But they do it on Disney Cruise Line.
Oh, that's good, yeah.
Yeah. I love this stamp artwork. That's very nice. This is the benefit of these rooms, and a lot of the time people will actually request these types of rooms to be able to have a bigger veranda. Because you get all of that space, private, just for us.
How does this... All right.
That's how curtains work, Gary. Yep, there we go.
Okay, let me remember how to do the door.
Lovely. Ooh.
Yeah, it's massive, absolutely massive.
La la la. You see everyone else's cabins?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Big to you too.
So you've got this bit which other cabins could in theory look down to you, which is probably the only negative with this extra space. But actually, if we were to sit in these chairs at the back, this is undercover. So it's not like you don't have any protection.
Lots of
from rain and stuff.
Early morning yoga.
As if. Not on this cruise. But so if you were in another family veranda room and you didn't have the extended veranda, this is the portion you would have as part of your stateroom.
Oh, okay.
So it's quite a big space that you gain.
There's a lot more added on.
Yeah. So when we went to guest services and asked if there was any other rooms available, just because if we're going to be on the ship for a week, with the category of room that we've been put in, we would probably prefer the extra space, because sometimes the pull-down bed can be a bit more comfortable, and you just get a bit more cupboard space and stuff like that, which for a week makes a difference. They basically said to us that because at the moment it looks like every single stateroom is full, we don't have any availability to move you right now, but what we can do is put a note on your account, and if once everyone's boarded there is a cabin free, we can potentially offer that to you. So he said it's unlikely we'll be moving, but there's still a chance, so we'll see what happens. But if it is full, that's what you can potentially do, is just hold out hope.
Mm-hmm.
Thoughts on the room?
I like it. I like the extra bit outside. You can get a little cheese plate to the room, sit out there.
Ooh, you know I love my cheese plate.
I can watch you eat the cheese and dream of times gone by.
As I bought the rainforest pass, I just need to add this little sticker they gave me to my card so that I can just hand that in when I'm going into the rainforest room. Here they have the Buena Vista Theatre. I don't think there's anything on right now, so we're going to have a little nosy. This is where Disney show their films, and they show their wares. But this is where they show new run films. If they've just come out of the cinema, the day they come out in the cinema in the US is the day they come on the ships as well. So there were people who got to watch Avengers for the first time on a Disney cruise.
Oh, wow.
Which is wild. We're going to learn how to draw Mickey Mouse now in the D-Lounge. This is very, very lively, isn't it?
Drama.
I'm following the instructions, but somebody didn't keep to the instructions.
Here's Goofy in one of his first rolls.
My energy levels are depleting, so we're gonna see if we can top it up with some caffeine. Lovely.
Let's
for us to get two coffees, one chai chi latte, one caramel latte, with an 18% gratuity that came to $14. But you get your little punch card. I haven't got it out right now, but if you collect, I think it's 5 drinks, you get one for free. And over a week cruise, we'll probably do that.
Christmas lights!
And those are the evacuation lights.
So we're heading to our muster drill. We just need to follow the green lights down to deck 4 and then find our letter, which is D. And you can find that on your card.
Lele.
We have won the muster drill lottery because our muster drill is in the theatre. We get to sit down. Because sometimes if, I think you've probably seen in the last series that we did, if you watch, if you're a subscriber, don't forget, subscribe. You sometimes have to stand out on deck in lines. And it's quite close. We went a bit early last time.
Yeah.
So at least we'll get to, you know, have a perch.
My mother needs a perch.
Oh, I do.
I can see the pin from here.
D for Donald. So you need to have one key card from your stateroom to check in for your whole stateroom.
Hello and welcome to the BBC.
If you are unable to reach your stateroom for your life jacket, one will be provided by your assembly team. Thank you for your attention during this drill.
All right, everyone. Just a reminder, we are going to just issue row by row, so go ahead and remain seated.
Welcome aboard.
You are told to have a
Would we potentially choose our stateroom again so we can have that muster drill?
Yes, yeah. Every time. That was way better than doing it outside.
Yeah. Sing over the copyright. Make sure you can't hear it. But we want to show you what's going on.
Characters.
On this occasion, deck 12 has filled up quicker than deck 11. So you can probably see the top decks are really busy. But down here, we managed to get a pretty good spot.
Yeah!
massive selling point about these. So because you get the extra chairs with the extra space, these can come up as a footrest. Oh, don't mind if I do. Ugh. Naps time. Well, turns out if you were going to be
on a cruise where you're going to spend a lot of time outside, or you like going on the deck, I would really recommend this.
That's painful.
Like, it is nice actually having the extra space. And I think if you've had like a family of three, this would be quite nice. Like, if the little ones wanted to play around, or four.
I'm laughing because I've just realised if I was watching this, for someone that's lactose intolerant, he certainly puts that ice cream away.
And you had a latte.
And I had a latte that wasn't soy milk. Do you know what? Let's risk it. Let's see how it goes.
What's the worst that can happen?
I mean, well.
We are sailing away. Bye, Southampton. We'll see you in a week.
Oh, it's come away really fast.
It's just foghorn. Oh, there we go.
London.
London.
Shout outs
to Betty Shambles.
Betty Shambles girl.
I miss Betty Shambles. Disney World, please bring back Betty Shambles. We loved her.
Get a winner's medal at the end of this.
We've started the unpacking process. I've already seen a preview of what Gary's got lined up for Pirates Night. I've also got something, so you're going to want to stick around for that vlog.
Your eyes do not deceive you. He has brought tea bags. Why have you brought tea bags?
I'm British and I like my tea bags. Soothe me. I'm very sorry, Disney, but we're going to have to talk about this. So, I went to open the bathroom door. This fell off, and then I went to open the cupboard, and then this fell out. So, we maybe should tell someone about that.
I just wanted to wear a Christmas hat.
Why are you wearing a Christmas hat?
Because I saw you had them in there, so I opened them. Oh, they're soft, aren't they? Available now, possibly in stock, no one knows.
We can't tell. If it's sold out, sorry.
We can't tell the future. Oh, this is nice. I miss it when it's like cold. He says about to go on a cruise.
Hello. The light is on the outside of the bathroom. So I'm going to turn it off.
Ah! Turn it back on!
I feel like everything on this ship is falling apart.
Look.
Now the barrier thing's broken off. Oh no. Time to get on the phone to the people.
So there I am, having a meeting with my lawyer in the toilet. All I hear is Gary going like, oh my God, the thing's come off! And I'm like, what is going on? And I hear this message of like, dush, dush, dush. I was like, what is he doing out there? So once I'd like sorted myself out, I then come outside to Gary being like, I don't know what to do, I don't know what to do.
It was chaos, it was a disaster. There was bits flapping everywhere. Flip, flappity, flip, flap, flap, flap. And I was just like, I don't know what to do. And then just by chance, is it Malvin?
Yes.
Malvin, our stateroom host, was walking past. We've ushered him in. He's fixed the thing. Done. Crisis over. And this was nothing to do with me. Make sure you remember that. Nothing to do with me.
I don't know what happened, so I can't verify that.
I was out there when it started.
Oh, well, there you go. You probably went, I wonder what this is.
Mm-mm. Can I lean on this for a better picture? I didn't do that. That is not what happened. That is not facts.
I've also ordered, we're not going to the show this evening. It's a magician and we just want to like chill and unwind. So I've ordered myself a cheese plate. You know how much I love a cheese plate. And also because of Castaway Club, I get a free bottle of Prosecco. So we're going to probably give it to someone around the ship.
This photo is insane.
It is a bit.
Can you see that?
It's you. And you. Out of the platinum and pearl complimentary gifts, you get either a bottle of Prosecco, a box of chocolates, or a fruit bowl. Obviously, a bottle of Prosecco is more valuable, but we don't really drink.
I'm not a drinker.
So we normally get this and then like get chatting to someone and go, do you like Prosecco?
Here for you.
And but this
is all for me. La la la. La la. Oh, a baby bell. Baby bell?
Do you know, I've watched a guy on TikTok that makes sculptures out of the wax that's around him. Fascinating fact.
That's great. Do you want a baby bell?
Nah. Just waving.
The case of... The case of water has arrived, which has usually come like this, and we've also got the bag that Gary's put into his bag, because obviously I got it previously.
I'm losing my mind. I'm just...
Losing? I thought we'd lost it a while ago.
Yeah.
Gary Cam makes a comeback. Is there dust on this lens? Oh, I don't know. Anyway, having a nice time. And, yeah. I think we're going to go out to deck four now and take a few little pictures as the sun goes down on this part of town. What's the words?
We're having to go back to the room because I can't walk in my Crocs.
Because literally he's walking next to me and I'm like, what's the matter with you? And he's going, boom, 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 boom.
I'm not used to
You should know by now, my biggest tip is never try and bring in new shoes on a Disney holiday. Ah, this is more like it.
Ah, that's nice.
We love the air.
Time for a photo.
Oh look, we're following another cruise ship over there.
What? Just because I'm always like tense and anxious, even as you're sort of like laying back, I'm like this. Like, I'm relaxing.
Do I look human?
I've got like a silver anniversary glow in the atrium.
Oh.
Also, newsflash. It gets really cold at night now.
Well, literally, we were passing, and the second the sun went in, and like a cloud had come over, we were like, ooh, nippy out here.
We've got the number one type on the seven seas, it's Donald Duck! And of course, the Cheeky Chipmunks themselves, Chip and Dale!
No idea what that was, but it was great. I didn't even know it was on the schedule. May we?
Can I get a picture first of just you and your dress? Because it looks amazing.
It's crazy they didn't put that on the schedule. Or maybe it wasn't on the schedule, we just didn't know what it was.
Maybe, but we've seen Rapunzel walking around, we've seen Belle walking around. Yeah, they just dispersed and it was just like everyone was getting selfies with all the characters. It was amazing. And then obviously all the...
And it wasn't as busy as the farewell show that you saw in the last one. You were like,
that was really good.
Yeah.
So we'll have to look up what that is called to recommend it, because that was good.
I just got chatting to one of our viewers, but Gary was like, oh, I'm just going to go take a picture of the pianist. And what happened?
So basically she was playing this really beautiful song and I said like, oh, you're incredible. And then she said, requests? And I was like, what? She went, requests? So I said, Beauty and the Beast. And then she played this incredible arrangement of Beauty and the Beast. I'm sitting there trying to film it on my phone. I'm shrinking like...
We're just a few minutes away from dinner. We did pop down to Emmett's Pub to see if they'd opened early. They haven't, and they don't normally. My advice is to go 10 or 20 minutes after dinner has opened, if you're first or second seating. Because what tends to happen on the first night is there's a big long line of people and they have to show each party to their table individually. And because of that, the line is very long, it takes a while, and so by the time that you've waited 10, 15 minutes or so, you will just go down and be at the back of the line and walk straight in. We went on the Dream earlier this year and we filmed a lot of Royal Palace. and a bit of Enchanted Garden. We haven't shown a lot of the animated palette, so I will show you this evening, but just as a note, if I haven't shown you a lot of the meals, that's why. If you want to go and see more of what Royal Palace is like and Enchanted Garden, go and check out our last series, which I'll link in the description box below. Any thoughts?
We just saw a man smoking next to a sign that says strictly no smoking, and he just looked so nonchalant. We both walked past and went,
Hi! Hello. What's your date? 60. 60? Yes. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60. 60.
aprons, there's like an animation thing on the walls, and normally you'd have like Crush. And also, the menu looks different. Like it's all fireworks and stuff, but I don't know why. We've had a chat with our server, we've worked out what this is. So on longer cruises, if you are going to be in Animator's Palette more than twice, so this is typically only on long cruises like 7, 10, 13, etc. You'll end up having this menu, which I've just shown you. And also, it's like an animator special, so all the costume is like colourful aprons, and yes, and it's a new menu. I love new menus.
Gary's going to go for the mozzarella and tomato bruschetta starter. I'm going to have the chicken bastilla, because I've never had that before, and it sounds very exciting. I'm also going to try a clam chowder. I've tried a little bit of Rachel's in Disney World before, but this one I'd like to give it a go. Gary's going to have the penne arrabbiata, and I'm going to try the grilled chicken breast.
Mozzarella, tomato, and prosciutto bruschetta.
And then this is the chicken basilla?
Yeah.
When I say that's possibly the best thing I've ever had on Disney Cruise Line,
that's a 5-star plus. Here's a look at the clam chowder. I'm a little bit apprehensive about trying this, but you know, it's all about trying new things when it's already been included.
What is clam chowder?
It's a chowder with clam in it.
That's not the goose, that's the clam.
The clam chowder is not a bit of me. I did have a little try, but it was just not to my liking. So you win some, you lose some.
I've gone for the chicken breast, and Gary has gone for the penne arrabbiata with shrimp.
Come on!
Let the magic begin!
One of our lovely viewers said not to get the mango cheesecake because she didn't think it was all that. So, mango cheesecake is off.
I think I'm just going to have a decaf coffee. Oh, my dessert?
Yes.
I thought I didn't order a dessert.
You did.
Nothing. Thank you very much. Ooh, delicious.
I mean, I actually like those little Mickey hundreds and thousands.
Leave it alone, this is my nothing.
Review of Animator's Palette.
Brilliant.
Still taking pictures, don't worry. That was possibly my favourite meal in Animator's Palette, so if you get a chance to have that menu...
Yeah.
If you're on a week cruise, when we went to the dining man on deck two, when we boarded the ship to check on our solo table, you can potentially request to be in this rotation so you can come here 3 times.
And that was really nice.
It was really good.
Really nice. Also, look at the floor. I've never even noticed this.
I knew you were looking at something that you need to take a picture of.
I love the floor.
Magical. An after dinner drink? Don't mind if I do.
I need to find the toilet, so toodaloo.
In sitting down, they've given us 25th anniversary coasters. Oh my god, I wish they sold these. Look how cute they are. We're currently passing through deck 5, and a fun fact about deck 5 is they've made the ceiling a bit shorter to make the kids feel like they're taller. This isn't your show.
Dear Disney, why'd you make these so hard? Because I just walked full pelt into that.
And that hurt. What towel animal do Adam and Gary have?
Ooh, I hope it's an elephant.
Ooh, it's a penguin. And for you.
For me, because you had it on the last one.
Just put it down so you can take a picture. Oh, it is cold though. Let's turn that aircon off.
Oh, no, I like the nips.
Just because you like the nips doesn't mean it's suitable. Gary was just saying that I always put my pyjamas like on the pillow and they always put them on his bed.
So whenever I come into the room, he's probably not aware of this, but I'm always having to do this. Just be like, here we go again. So he thinks they've always been put there.
I do always think, I'm like, oh, it's very good that they put my pyjamas out.
It's cute.
I suppose.
It's like a baby.
I'm just a baby.
I'm just a bubble with no beak.
Beak. We suspect you've watched a very long embarkation day.
You know when it's been a long day? I was about to go, morning.
Anyway, don't forget to subscribe if you're not already a subscriber, because we obviously have more vlogs to come in this series where we're touring the whole UK. Yeah. And we hope you'll stick around.
Crazy store.
That's it. Don't call it come back. We never went away. Don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the other future. Thank you so much for watching. And we'll see you next time.